Hi guys, welcome back to Math in a Hoodie. I'm so excited you're here with me today. I have put on my favorite hoodie and we are going to talk about some math. Are you guys ready to do some math? So today we're going to learn about adding and subtracting. Do you know what add and subtract means? Let's talk about that for a minute before we do a couple of problems, okay? So when we add something together, we put it all together, right? If your mom says, add all your toys up on your bed, you bring all your toys together, right? And if you subtract, that means you're gonna take something away. If your mom says, that's too much candy, subtract a couple of pieces, that means you would take a couple pieces out, right? So to add means to put together, and subtract means to take some away, okay? So today we're gonna practice doing add and subtraction up to number 5. Can you count to 5? Let's count to 5 so that I know that you can do the simple addition and subtraction problems. Are you ready? You can count on your fingers if you want. Just say it with me, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. And if we wanted to count on our fingers, we'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, wouldn't we? Good job, guys. Now that I know you can count up to 5, I know that you can do these 3 math problems I have. Should we try them? Okay, so let's do our first problem, okay? Can you see this? It says 2 plus or add 1. Now, when I do math, it helps me so much if I use objects when I add or subtract. So let's see if we can use some objects to help us find these answers, okay? So for the first one, I found these little signs I have. Now the first number it shows us is 2. So I found 2 signs. One is a little fire and one's a heart. So I have 2 signs, don't I? Okay, now it says 2, add 1. So we have 2 and we need to add 1 to it. How about a thumbs up? Here's our 2 and we're gonna add this 1 to it. Now how many do we have? Well, we have 1, 2, 3. We have 3, don't we? So when we took 2 and we added 1, we got 3. Let's go ahead and write 3 as our answer, okay? Now, if you needed to do that and you didn't have pictures or something to use, you could draw little circles, okay? There's 2 circles. And we need to add 1 more circle to it, didn't we? So how many circles do we have together now? 1, 2, 3. Did we get the same answer? We did. So you can use anything around your house to add together to make sure that your answer is correct, okay? All right, let's do the second one, all right? It says 0 plus 3. 0. Well, 0 means nothing, zilch, right? So if we start with 0, we're going to add 3 things to it. So for this one, I have 3 markers, right? 1, 2, 3. So I have 3 markers and I'm going to add 0 to it. If I put them together, what do I have? I still only have 3, don't I? Because if you add nothing to it, then this number doesn't change. So 0 plus 3 equals 3, huh? Okay, so let's write our answer down. Look, our answer is gonna be the same as number 1. They're both 3. Okay, now let's say we didn't have markers. We could just do dots, huh? So 0 dots, adding 3 dots. So if we started with 0, we wouldn't put any dots up for the first number, would we? And then we add three dots. So how many is it total now? One, two, three. We got the same answer. Good job. You guys, this is so easy. You're doing such a good job. Let's do the very last one. So for the last one, we have three, add two. Okay, so for three, we need something that we have three of. So I grabbed three of my Little Mermaid dolls. One, two, three. Do you see my three dolls? Okay, now how many more dolls do we need to add to three? Well, we have three and we need to add two more. Ooh, lucky I have two more. Here we go. One, two. Can you see these two mermaids? And over here we have three. They want us to add these three and these two together. That's a lot of mermaid dolls. Let's see how many we have now. Should we count them? One, two, three, four. Oh my gosh, I can't fit all of them in my hand. Five. We have five mermaid dolls, don't we? Because three add two more means five dolls total. Okay, let's write down our answer. It's five. Good job. Now, if we didn't have dolls or anything else to use, we could do circles, or what about just straight lines like a stick? Let's try that. So our first number was three. So we did three sticks. Now it wants us to add two more. One, two. Okay, let's add them up and see if we got the same answer. I bet we did, because you guys are super smart at adding. One, two, three, four, five. Guys, is that the same answer that we got? It is. Good job. So three add two equals five. Oh, you guys are so good at adding. Should we try some subtracting now? I think we should. Let's try three samples of some subtracting problems. Okay, now that we've practiced adding numbers, let's subtract numbers, which means we're going to take some away, right? Okay, so I've got three samples of subtraction problems here, and let's do them together. Now, we're going to use some objects to help us do the problem, right? So we can check our answer. So the first one says 5 minus or subtract 1. So that means we have 5 of something and we're going to take 1 away, right? So I have 5 hands, or maybe they're gloves, right? And I have 5 of these. Should we count them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're blue and green and orange and red, aren't they? So we have 5 hands or gloves, and it says we need to subtract 1. So let's take one of these and put it off to the side. Now, how many is left? Because that's going to be our answer, right? Well, let's count. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So our answer is 4. 5 take away 1 is 4. So let's write our answer there. Now, if you didn't have anything to use, remember you could just write a mark. Let's do check marks this time, shouldn't we? So we start with 5, right? So let's do 5 check marks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we're going to take away or subtract 1. So let's go ahead and erase this 1 over here, right? Now, however many's left is our answer. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that what we wrote here? It is. Good job. So 5 subtract 1 is 4. We did that correct, guys. Good job. Okay, let's do the next one. It says 3 subtract or minus 3. Okay, so let's go ahead and get out three items, and then we'll go ahead and do that problem. Okay, the next one says 3, subtract 3. So for this one, the first number's 3, I got out 3 little ping pong balls. Have you ever played ping pong before where you hit it with the paddle? It's really fun. I have 3 different colors, don't I? I have a yellow, a green, and a pink. So I have 3 ping pong balls. Now it says that take away 3 from the 3. So we have 3 balls, and it says to take 3 of them away. So 1 we'll put over there, 2 we'll put over there, and 3 we put over here. Now how many's left, guys? They're all gone, aren't they? If we have 3 and we take all the 3 away, we're left with 0. So our answer for 3 subtract 3 is 0. There's nothing left, okay? If you take away the same number you started with, you're never going to have anything, no matter what the number is. If you have 5 and someone ate all the 5 cookies, there would be no cookies left, huh? If you had 2 popsicles and you ate both the popsicles, there'd be nothing left, wouldn't there? Okay, you guys are doing really good. Let's do the last one, okay? We have 4, subtract or take away 2. So for this one, I'm gonna use these party blowers. Have you ever seen these? It blows out the little paper at the end. Usually makes a noise, but it's not. All right, so I got 4 of those. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4. And should we tell what the color is too? What color is that? Green, pink, yellow, and blue. Good job. You guys are knowing your colors. That's awesome. So we have 4 party blowers. And how many do we need to subtract or take away? 4, subtract 2. So here's our 4. Let's take 2 of them away. Let's take away the green and the pink. Okay, we took away 2. Now how many is left? 1, 2. There's 2 left. So 4, subtract 2. Is 2. Let's go ahead and make some circles and see if we got the right answer, shall we? The first number was 4, so let's go ahead and write 4 circles up there. Now we need to subtract 2, so let's erase the last 2. How many does that leave us, guys? It leaves us with 2, doesn't it? Kind of looks like the eyes of a smiley face. So we have 2 left over. Is that what we wrote? It sure is, huh? 4 subtract 2 is 2. Good job. You guys, you're doing so good at subtracting and adding. I'm so proud of you. Remember that it helps to use an object when you're adding or subtracting. Your fingers, your toys, you can write circles or check marks, whatever helps you so you can learn how to add and subtract and check your answers, right? Okay, well, thanks for practicing with me today, you guys. You did so good, and I will see you next time on Math in a Hoodie.